Hi, we have Sheldon from TravelBiz Monitor joining us today. Hi, Sheldon. So, how's GPS been so far?
Arun, GPS has been good. Mm-hmm. I've been here now almost seven years. And I see changes that's happening here. They may have shrunk in the number of exhibitors that they have, but I think they're concentrating now on quality. I think the infrastructure at GPS has improved a lot. If you look at the layout and design, it's more spaced out. You've got people visiting not just from Nagpur now, from other smaller towns. I think they've got the model right. I think what they're doing in Nagpur and then replicating it in other cities is the right model. Mm-hmm. I do see changes. I see new people coming in. I see a lot of the old ones going out. But that's just the cycle of the tourism industry that I see. So I think all's good as long as they keep going this way.
How's TravelBiz Monitor doing? How has been the journey in the last 10 years?
It's been an up and down journey, because it's been punctuated at the start when we started in 2007 and 2008. We were unfortunate to be, you know, perched just there on the cusp of that major meltdown that happened in the US with the Lehman Brothers, mm-hmm. starting all over the place, and then this cascading effect that was felt all over the world, including India. So we started in tumultuous times. We have settled down over the last few years. And then again, 2 or 3 years ago, it's been the demonetization, followed by GST, followed by slowdown in economy. So you've got to say that business is fun. There's never a dull moment.
So you've been a perfect survivor in that scenario, I guess.
Well, I wouldn't say perfect survivor, but yeah, we do our things. We innovate to survive. We've brought about a lot of innovation in the business.
And can you talk about the innovations a bit?
Yeah, so we started regularly as a media company, which was doing a lot of print way back then, 12 years, 13 years ago. From there, we were the first movers actually in the online space to set up a hardcore news portal for the Indian industry. That was Live. We actually started this together. We were a weekly print, mm-hmm. and a daily 24/7 news portal that was updated almost 20 times a day. So you could say it was the CNN or the BBC, travel news for India. From then on, we've actually seen print take its step backwards. We've actually seen, we then moved from a weekly to a fortnightly, and now in the interests of saving paper, saving costs, going green, we've actually made this a monthly. Mm-hmm. So we've got 2 or 3 magazines now that are monthly. TravelBiz is not the only one we run. We also run a title in hospitality, in corporate space, and in our architecture. We have innovated in terms of being the website that was there. We're not just doing a website now. We have done newsletters, we do video, we do online training, which is a model that's been adapted from around the world to train the travel industry and the stakeholders in products and services and destinations. We were among the first to introduce the webinars in India, which has made a huge impact. We were among the first to introduce interactive digital magazines. Mm-hmm. So all our magazines now are now available in the digital space with in interactive media, with videos, with the whole thing. So over the years, yes, we have kind of adapted and moved away from our model that has been only print into various other things. Mm-hmm. This has also been backed up by the events capability that we've created. And we've moved into the corporate space because we recognize that MICE and business travel today is probably the fastest growing part of the travel segment. So we have consciously moved into events and the corporate space and not just the travel trade.
And you mentioned about going green, going digital and bringing in those initiatives. So GPS has made a big step in this direction. Last 4 years, they've managed to kind of save about 50,000 kilos of paper, which technically translate to about 5,000 trees. So what is your individual contribution and the organization contribution towards the Go Green initiative?
So actually, let me say a few things about GPS first. They've been innovators in various ways, actually. Not in the exhibition space, they were the first ones who actually saw the power of the 2 and 3 tier cities where the others didn't really. Mm-hmm. And even now they're probably the largest group of exhibitions that are doing it in 2- and 3-tier cities. So that itself was innovation. And you know, you got to congratulate the family on that, with Harmandeep, his brother, and the rest of them who are involved. After that, what they've also done is they've got this Go Green thing, where about 3 or 4 years ago they you know said, don't bring visiting cards, don't bring brochures or pamphlets, do everything on an app. And they've organized it, you know, they've actually organized the entire show on the app. And I think that again is the first in India. And they were the first ones to move into that. Right now, yeah, so they've saved a whole lot of things by doing that. Even their structure this year is an environment-friendly structure. So they're doing away with flexes, and they're doing away with the regular backdrops, in substituting it by eco-friendly materials. So in that way, I have to say that GPS has been very innovative in what they're doing. Coming to us, I'm not sure that we've contributed too much to the Go Green initiative and the zest of GPS, simply because we are a media company, and just showing videos on a backdrop is not enough, because our product is a magazine or magazines. So we've had to print those magazines and bring them here to show it. The only contribution I can say to that is that we bring less magazines than we used to. We bring less magazines than we used to bring out here and show. And we do show a lot of other stuff that we do in the online space. But so we'd be probably the least, the least contribution to the Go Green initiative of GPS.
I think your answers were right from the heart and candid.
Totally.
It takes a lot to accept, but to be able to even recognize and being aware is a big step towards it. So thank you very much for joining us.
Thanks, Arun.
Have a wonderful evening.
Pleasure. And I wish the dope all the best.
Thank you.